Ladies and gentlemen, what you've been experiencing is a small microcosm of what it must have been like with countless encounters on the European battlefield between American forces sweeping in after D-Day to the closing days in May of 1945. And what we try to capture here is for another generation to understand that their grandfathers and great grandfathers were 19 years old, asked to defend civilization. And we would hope that your participation here today, watching these exercises, will open the conversation and allow another generation of Americans to understand the sacrifice of not only this generation of GIs, but everybody who has worn the American uniform. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have to start clearing the field of some of these vehicles, respotting them, and then what we're going to do is we'll wind up running a number of them individually, and then we're going to look to run them as a parade, which is frankly quite unique in the Northeast. There is no other place that has a collection of operational vehicles quite like this, and we hope you will engage all the living historians. Gentlemen, thank you very much. Again, a round of applause for guys who put in an awful lot of volunteer time. You bet. They put in a lot of work and a lot of effort in order to honor the GI.
The Germans are down there. And stand out here and watch. Yeah, this is play soldier. Yeah. slightly smaller load and real tape that's a little noisier.
The exercise concludes with casualties on both sides and the POW. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear a round of applause for the Reenctors of the Military Encampment and the Military Encampment and the Military Encampment. I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank each and every veteran.
Look up, the only thing I would suggest is this, and this is how I can, reach this. Look up the movie, go to Google or someplace, look up
the movie. We're on a Saturday morning.
And what we would find is this. This is a Leica, and it would say, she picked up her Leica.
Leica must have made 30 different cameras.
Just don't ask him how he sounds.
I didn't know.